We've had plenty of hunting and fishing adventures with veterans over the years, but one local group is trying something a little different. Their mission is to help Delmarva veterans train their own service dogs.
And remember, we want them walking on our left-hand side.
There's a group of veterans that get together every week at the Holly Center in Salisbury, as well as other places on the shore, to train dogs. Chris Hardy is a certified pro trainer, and he started U.S. Kennels.
We actually take disabled veterans to train their own service dogs. It's kind of therapeutic for them, kind of gets them back into the real world, keeps them occupied, you know, instead of dwelling on the past and so forth.
And so goes the healing power of dogs. Believe it or not, these tail-wagging furballs are here for the purpose of helping their owners, all of whom are veterans, to be able to cope with normal day-to-day activities.
It's very common for veterans to not really even leave their house. We've had a couple people in our program have been out of the house in 6 years, unless it's to the VA or doctor. Other than that, they're home. So with giving them a dog and having them train their dog, gets them out and about.
It got me out of the house. I've been stuck at home for months and months.
Mimi Burrows is just one of the 25 plus veterans who are part of this program.
I just really was afraid to be around people. And I felt comfortable with other veterans and my dog and their dogs.
Mimi has only recently discovered U.S. Kennels, and she drives every week from Easton to Salisbury to train with Chris and her fellow veterans. But just what is it that this little 7-year-old dog named Rocky does to help Mimi?
And like when I'm upset, Rocky knows without me telling him, he'll jump right up on my lap and put his head on my shoulder. And to me, that's amazing.
And thanks to these amazing animals, these veterans are able to come together and triumph over their battles with both visible and invisible wounds.
We have a couple people have a TBI, a traumatic brain injury. Well, from that, they have seizures. These dogs can actually sense a seizure before it comes full blown. A lot of people have come back with PTSD. With that, along comes with anxiety, depression. We have nightmares, flashbacks, sleep deprivation, and we do have some people that are bound to wheelchair amputees, so they can actually be, these dogs can actually become a part of their body. You know, for our soft mouth retrieval, retrieving things, picking things up, these dogs actually save lives. I know for a fact, I'm a disabled veteran myself, that this works.
Chris Hardy started U.S. Kennels in 2016. It's a nonprofit program, and since it is fairly new, they're always on the lookout for public support. And since nearly all the dogs in the program are rescue dogs, Chris considers each team as two lives saved.
So once again, it goes to socialization. Socialization is a big part of what? Our training, right? Because that way, when we actually get out in the real world or doing something when we're on our own, the dogs aren't going to freak out.
After basic obedience and socialization, the focus becomes giving the dogs a job, which is what ultimately makes them service dogs.
Tasking, for example, would be if I have a flashback. The dog will either pick up the leash, nudge me, jump up on me to bring me back into, I guess you could say, the real world. Or if a person has an anxiety attack, or you know, it's, the crowd is too much for them, the dog is trained to actually take them out of the crowd.
With the help of each other and their dogs, Delmarva's veterans have been able to come together to wage a battle against their disabilities.
I feel a lot more comfortable out in public. I mean, I've actually gone to a few stores by myself. I've taken my dog, and people, I was kind of surprised, actually. I thought they would reject him, but actually the people are amazing.
And with the help of U.S. Kennels, these dogs will continue their mission, which is
saving veterans one paw at a time.